One of the first signs or symptoms of zinc deficiency is hair loss or hair thinning. Zinc supports the health and integrity of the hair follicles, which are the structures on our skin where the hair actually grows through. Without enough zinc, these structures are compromised and restrict the ability for the hair to grow. And the second reason for this is zinc supports a protein in our hair, which is responsible for hair length and hair strength called keratin. And without enough keratin production, the overall strength of our hair becomes a lot weaker, which then leads to thinning and, at our worst case scenario, the overall hair loss. Symptoms of low zinc can also include issues with our skin like acne or the inability for wounds to heal. And this is because zinc is involved in the production of collagen, which is essential for skin regeneration and particularly important for wound healing or scar healing. And in terms of acne, zinc helps regulate sebum production, which is an oil that our skin produces. But the issue is if we have too much sebum production, this can lead to blocking and clogging of the actual pores, which can lead to breakouts and acne. And another absolutely telltale sign of low or deficiency in zinc is you're someone who's always getting sick or always catching a cold. This is because zinc is essential for the development of immune cells like lymphocytes and natural killer cells. And what a name they have. And these cells help defend our immune systems against infection. So how can someone become deficient in zinc? Well, an interesting thing about zinc is our body has no natural storage of zinc. So we have to get it through our food every single day. And we have to get it through good quality nutrient dense foods, which is often the opposite to a lot of diets which are high in processed foods, which are depleted in not only zinc, but many of the key micronutrients we need like magnesium and iron. And diets too high in grains, which are often the case for a lot of the vegetarian or vegan communities, can actually block zinc absorption because these foods are high in a compound called phytates. And phytates can bind to the receptors in the digestive system and block the absorption of key minerals like zinc. So how do we ensure we're never going to be zinc deficient? Number one is we have to eat a diet of real whole foods that are high in zinc. Oysters, red meat, seafood, organ meats have some of the richest sources of zinc. And if you struggle to get enough zinc through food alone, then high quality zinc supplements like zinc glycinate and zinc picolinate will be able to support. And just remember, if you're going to supplement with zinc, of course, always check with your healthcare professional first, but make sure you keep the dose on the lower side at 10 to 15 milligrams of elemental zinc per day, as doses that are too high can actually cause imbalances of other key minerals like copper. But if you keep the dose low at 10 to 15 milligrams per day, which is still in line with daily recommended dietary intakes of 11 milligrams per day, then the risk of causing imbalances in other key minerals is a lot lower.